Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth series. Sorry about the audio in the last one. I know that the audio muted itself, but I didn't realize that the game audio had muted itself in OBS. For the record, the game audio was not muted for me, so I still heard all the sound effects and stuff in that last run, but for some odd reason, the game's audio was actually globally muted for OBS, and I have no idea how that happened, so apologies about that. Anyway, we're looking pretty good so far. We're on 11 game streak, and I will definitely take that, hoping for a good start. Been playing a lot of Enter the Gungeon lately, and it's going to feel pretty nice getting back to Isaac. Not that Isaac really went anywhere. This is about as nightmarish a start as it gets, because we have no idea how much HP we have. So your seed day is going to be November 0, Hotel X-Ray Bravo Quebec 9 X-Ray. We've got some decent range, decent damage, terrible movement speed, terrible tears rate, and no idea how much HP we have. So this is as nightmarish as we get. We do have a Tinted Rock right off the bat, which is good. We also start with a bomb as well as Butt Penny, which Butt Penny doesn't really matter all that much, but yeah, we gotta hope for something good. All right, we took a hit there, not too pleased about that. Again, our movement speed certainly is really, really lacking right now, but our damage is also just god awful. So, okay, that did not give us what I wanted, and I'm also going to just get rid of Butt Penny. I'm pretty sure no one's going to mind if I do that. So yeah, I'm just going to use Necronomicon here. No way I'm even messing with this. We did end up getting a sack from somewhere though, and I'm okay with that. Alright, so we end up picking up the Iron Bar, which is going to give us a little bit of a damage help. Just a little bit. We could go into our store. We do have two bombs. And there, of course, is no Soul Heart either. Eey. Oh boy! I think one bomb is good here just to get the nickel from the keeper. From the shopkeeper, that is. And do we try to buy this Red Heart to see if we are on Red Heart, on Red Heart HP right now? I think it might be worth it. Okay, so we were able to pick up the Red Heart, meaning that hit that we took from the Diglett, that tells us a lot about what we have. That means that, of course, A, we don't have any Soul Hearts, and B, it's very possible that we were one hit from death. So, again, with these sort of nightmare 1 HP, possible, you have to treat it like 1 HP. I mean, there's just no getting around it. I mean, every hit is a moment sort of thing, so we got to be really careful here. All right, there's another Red Heart there. I wish I would have known that Red Heart was there before I had bought the other one that for 3 cents, so that's okay. I'm not gonna be salty about it. Picking up an unusually large amount of money for just randomly here. So I would like to have the Necronomicon charge before we go fight the boss, but if push comes to shove here, I want to just get an HP upgrade. HP upgrade, speed, damage, all that stuff is relevant. The worst thing that we could get, oh, thank you. Thank you, Penny Sack. The worst thing that we could get would be like a range upgrade. That's about the only stat that we cannot benefit from at all right now. 13 cents, I might as well go check to see what that tarot card is. I'm also a little confused as to where the secret room would be. If it's not where I thought it was there, then it has to be to the left. No, it can't be to the left of this room. It has to be, I guess, to the left of the shop? Not entirely sure. Okay, we still did not get a Soul Heart, which I'm a little bit worried about, I'm gonna be honest. And we could buy the half price battery here, and this is gonna be a moon card. I might as well buy the battery. We don't know if that's going to come up later on in the run, but right now, of course, we're looking for basically any outs that we can get. And again, we have to treat this like we have 1 HP, like we have a half heart, that's it. I'm going to take a shot in the dark here for the super secret room. Did not happen, which I'm sad about. It's going to be Ragman, which is about as bad as it gets for the basement. Now, hopefully, Iron Bar is going to be able to keep him kind of under control. Ragman can be extremely dangerous, especially when you don't know how much HP you have and when you have low movement speed. So we're going to have to take a little bit more of a strategic approach here to one of the most annoying bosses that you can fight in the early goings here. Really hoping that Iron Bar procs on him again. That would be nice. There we go. So what Iron Bar will do is it will give them a concussion and basically slows their attacks as well as their movement speed, which is very, very good. It also stops any channeled ability that they do. Obviously, for bosses, you want to take as much control of the fight as possible. Nice little proc there on that jumping spider. Now, of course, he's going to start resurrecting these mummy spiders, which gives him a little bit of HP. And also, I believe it buffs him slightly. I do not want to get hit by the spiders at all. I almost reached for my mouse to hit a right click there so I could dodge roll. Alright, this constant healing thing is getting ridiculous, Ragman. We need to kill him before we kill another spider. He seriously got no HP game. Okay. So Ragman goes down, finally. And we get magic much, which is huge. That is monstrous. Now I'm going to do something that's even riskier, and that's going into the curse room. I could use the moon card to get out of the curse room, which might be the smartest move of them all. So that saves us an extra half heart, but we do have that full heart sitting on the room before the boss. So I did use it, and the secret room is somewhere that I would have never found it. So, but magic mush is huge. It gives us not only an all stats up, which is the best thing that we needed, it also gives us the much coveted HP. Of course, we also get a damage multiplier. Magic mush may have just saved the streak. Oh, and we had plenty of HP too. Well, it's still always good. It's better to be safe than sorry when you've got Curse the Unknown on an Eden streak. Like that combination is just, that's the game being as evil as possible. Like to have a character that has random everything and then it gives you, it won't let you see how much HP you have is just ridiculous. So I'm not ready to start. I mean, we just got out of the doghouse as far as like the danger zone goes. So like, I don't want to even risk with pills right now. We haven't really been having that good of luck with pills anyway lately. So Penny Sack is doing a pretty nice job keeping us supplied with a good amount of coinage here. And that's going to open up our options that makes this run even safer. But I really do think that Magic Mush, even though we, now that we know that we didn't need it. Oh man. Now that we know that we didn't need it, like Magic Mush not only brought up the morale, but also saved. I really do think that saved the streak, because if we had been down to like a half heart, I don't know where we stand from there. I'm not going to take this full charge just because we have the battery. There's no real pressing matter. Whoa, Daddy Long Legs. Careful now. I would happily open up this golden chest. I'll also happily open up the secret room, which is not happily there. I'm going to happily go into the happy store and happily purchase another soul heart, though. I'm not too big on the nightlight. If I get it for free, then that's kind of like great. But if I don't get it for free, I don't even want to mess with it. Necronomicon. I usually hate you. This time around, I'm not gonna hate. I ain't gonna judge. You're all right. In a weird way, we're also kind of blessed that we have the that we do have the Necronomicon, because that saves us a lot of possible headaches. See there, it doesn't really do that much damage to Little Horn. I need to not shoot the fire. I'm just going to let Daddy take this one. Take us home, Daddy. There we go. So we get HP. It's great. We go up to 4 HP. Deal with the Devil is going to be a little Brimstone, as well as the missing page number 2, which I might as well take. Should I take it here? It would give us an extra Soul Heart. I'm actually not going to take it. The reason being there is because I'm anticipating us getting like a Demon Judgment. And I'm hoping that maybe it'll work out to where we can take multiple swings on that. Not swigs, that would be something completely different. Hey, can I call it or what? Okay, well now I feel like I'm super duper smart and vindicated and all that kind of good stuff, so. Okay, that did not, it didn't end the way that I wanted to, and I'm not gonna even tempt fate right now. If we had more HP, then yeah, I'm all for it. And of course, we do have a little Brimstone, so that makes me feel a little bit better about our choices here. But again, we're not completely safe. And I'm certainly not going to go back into the curse room. I mean, we could, but that basically ruins our deal with the devil on this floor if we get one. So no curse. We still rocking with the Necronomicon here. And of course, Daddy Longleg, which is premier hard carry item 2016. Not trying to be facetious either. I truly mean it. I mean, if you want Daddy, if you want just a good hard carry item, I mean that's Daddy Long Legs. If you, all you need is Daddy Long Legs and you get Gnawed Leaf, that is that. You're set. Literally is unlosable, but it's gonna be the longest run of all time. But desperate times calls for desperate measures. I have done that before. I have beaten Blue Baby on a on. I don't remember if it was an Eden run or not, but I have had to scum it up and basically just sit there and let Nod Leaf make me invincible, and then have Daddy Longlegs basically just do the rest. Oh my goodness, the Necronomicon didn't one-shot these. And on top of that, we lost a Soul Heart. I'm not too happy about that game. I can't believe the Necronomicon did. I mean, I know they're champion mobs, but I was expecting them to get dealt a lot more damage. This just screams secret room up here, but we only have one bomb, and we really, really need a Soul Heart. Although I think that our chances of getting a deal with Devil on this floor are pretty minute. Yeah, this has got to be the secret room here. And we got an extra bomb anyway, even if it was not. All right, two extra bombs. I'm not going to complain about that. Should we go fight the boss now? We might as well. I mean, Mega Fatty. Not too terribly pleased to see Mega Fatty. He's not exactly a give-me boss. I'm also going to take care of the poop that's in our way. Mega Fatty's... It's deceptively fast sometimes. So we did not get deal with the devil, but we did get PJs, which is going to give us a lot of soul hearts, as well as, I believe, a little bit of range as well. So, as well. There we go. So we are taken care of. Again, no surprise that we didn't get a deal with the devil. We did get hit, even though it wasn't red heart damage. But we also just got done getting a deal with the devil, so it's okay. It could be a lot worse. Considering how we started, it could definitely be a lot worse. Let's go check out the shop. You gotta be. That's the reason why you gotta be careful with the iron bar. Okay. We're dodging there by the skin of our teeth there, Daddy Longlegs. I mean, I appreciate everything that you're doing for us, but you gotta be careful with that. Again, I'm not gonna take pills. I don't see any reason to at this point. We got Magic Mush. I would hate to start tanking some of our stats because of that. It's just not worth it. IMO is just not worth it. I'd be confused with LMAO, which is a pop culture reference that I, suffice to say, don't understand. But I made it anyway, just because that's just how the internet works. As long as the person with the microphone says it, it's popular and hilarious, right? Yeah. Probably not. Here's a shop. I will happily buy this soul heart. And what is in this tarot card? It's going to be a chariot card. Okay. So chariot will give us temporary invincibility, which would have, A, stopped that from happening, and B, also would allow us to play a Demon Judgment once we find one. And yeah, so we just basically wasted the 5 cents that we paid for the Soul Heart, which I'm very, very happy to say that I'm proud of, and as well as we got Cherry Card. But hey, we got PJs, we have stats now, we're looking good. Again, Magic Mush, little Brimstone for the carry, we are doing okay. It's not a one run by any means, but we're in much better territory than we were. Not even gonna mess with this, thank you. Something I should mention real quick for those of you who might be a little bit newer players to Isaac, and specifically talking about the Necronomicon, you don't want to use Necronomicon as soon as you get into a room. You want to wait for like at least half a second. Do a one Mississippi count off, because there are times where if you activate the Necronomicon too quickly, the enemies technically have not loaded yet, and it will not do any damage. Same goes for like death cards and that sort of thing. Oh my god. Well, we're looking pretty good. I mean, we did just get, you know, another damage multiplier, which does not stack with Magic Mush, but still gives us damage up anyway. And another Soul Heart. Hopefully this time we don't throw this one down the tubes. Probably will. And I'm not going to play the Blood Bank quite yet, because I've seen it disproven that if you take red heart damage from a blood bank, it doesn't count against your deal with the devil status, but I've also seen the contrary happen just as much. So, wow. Yeah, and that, talking about throwing away our soul heart, there you go. Somehow we got hit by lust. I don't know how that happened, but it did. So yeah, I'm a little bit on the superstitious side when it comes to not using blood banks. I'm going to go back and try to get the HP upgrade, because of course I want the speed, and of course the more HP right now, the better. But I don't want to jeopardize our deal with the devil status for it. That will also allow us to get into the mob trap room, which is, or a boss trap room rather, which is going to be very, very nice, hopefully. Secret room's above us, I am almost guaranteeing it. We're gonna have the Necronomicon for the big clear in the big room as well, which is nice. More money is always good. I will go to the curse room, but not until after we fight the boss. Now, ideally, what are we looking for in the... What are we looking for in the deal with the devil here? We're looking for, I mean, obviously, anything that's a hard carry. Brimstone, Mom's Knife. Even though we just got done with a Brimstone run, I'm totally that guy. Like, I don't care what we got on another run because I just want to win this run. Sort of thing. Like, it's an Eden streak, you know? Like, we gotta... You gotta take the wins that you can get, sort of thing. If the game tosses you a softball and you don't take it, then you've got no room to complain on the ones when it starts to decide playing hardball. Getting lots of keys from randomly, too, which is kind of nice. This is a very long floor. Nice job, little Brimstone. Good to know there's a second, there's a half heart there in case we do need some more red heart HP if we don't get a payout from the chariot card on the blood bank. And even more red hearts, good. Alright, it's gonna be stained. I used Necronomicon there. Sometimes the adds can get a little out of control for Stain. And coming from Gungeon to Isaac now, like I look at this and like, oh, this ain't no. I've seen some real bullet hell. That's not even close. Alright, we get growth hormones, speed, and damage. Of course it's gonna be Krampus. Which is to be expected. So we get an early Krampus tax out of here, which is good. And even if we get something like the, actually, I don't know if I would take Krampus's head over the Necronomicon. Surprising, I know, but, like, I don't consider Krampus's head that good anymore. If it didn't do their whole rotation thing, then I probably would be a lot higher on it. Yeah, I'll take a World Garden. Actually, no. I wanted to... No, the HP upgrade that we can get potentially from the blood bank is way more valuable than the world card. In my opinion. Some people might feel differently about that. Alright, so we're gonna go... Let's go to the curse room first. Or not the curse room, but the arcade first, just to get this out of the way. We'll go back down to the boss trap room. Oh wow, paid out with a dime. Alright, well, Three Skull Monty, we'll be back. Growth Hormone, by the way, gives us a damage and a very nice speed boost, as you can see. So we have great movement speed now. Really good damage, relatively anyway. We got our HP back from that we just spent on the blood bank, which is good. It saves us a little bit of time from backtracking. I am shocked that he made it that far. Normally, Mega Fatty does not jump that far, but I guess joke's on me. I could have totally dodged that. I just was not expecting him to make it there. He normally stops a little bit before the door. Alright, so sloppy play, admit. It's not the game's fault, it's mine. Alright, so the curse room and the boss trap room was a complete bust. Now we can focus on getting this blood bag payout, hopefully. You didn't really give us what we needed there, blood bank. We did get two keys from Three Skull Monty, though. Okay, this is this is getting a little bit silly here. Oh my goodness, we got the dollar. You want to talk about super rare items? The dollar is very, very, very rare, especially in Afterbirth. I think this might be the first time. Where was that heart at? Anyway. This might be the first time I've seen the dollar in Afterbirth. So, obviously the dollar is 99 cents, but, oh wait, we can't get to those hearts. I'm gonna be sad if I'm not gonna get this blood bank. I'd have wasted so much time and the boss rush. But the dollar is 99 cents, and it's extremely rare. It can only be paid out from arcades. Or not arcades, but, slot machines. Right, I'm gonna toss a bomb your way, Three Skull Monty, and you're gonna give me a red heart. Never mind. We don't have any red hearts because I'm an idiot. I don't remember what was inside of our shop, but now that we've got plenty of cash money, we're just gonna go check it out. And there's a heart and a key. I mean, might as well. 99 cents. You've got options. Anybody who said that money does not equal happiness was clearly not talking about the Binding of Isaac. All right, well, I tried. I could go back and, or I could try to win a bomb from Three Skull Monty and bomb this one, but we've already wasted enough time. I was hoping it paid out. It didn't. I'm a little bit sad that we didn't get the, or we're not going to be able to take our world card, but again, world card's not that big of a deal. We got the Krampus tax out of the way, we lost some HP, but we gained damage and speed, of course, thanks to growth hormones, and that's very good. Now this, on the other hand, is kind of annoying, but I forgot that we had Daddy Longlegs. It's been so long since we actually fought something, like, that was a new thing. Whoa! Curse the maze! Slow down. We still got hit anyway, so joke's on me, I guess. Yeah, we don't have any bombs. Okay, well, I almost am certain that the secret room is to the north of this room here. Well, that room. You know which one I'm talking about. Before Curse of the Troll keeps on messing with me. There's something about Curse of the Maze that just irritates me to no end. Like, I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's the fact that the screen shakes or that it seems to proc at the most inopportune moments. But man, when you get those like 3, 4, sometimes even 5 like procs from Curse of the Maze, it is absolutely just infuriating. Unicorn poop is gonna heal us for some odd reason. We get bombs. It's gonna allow us to get into the curse room. I almost thought about using the Necronomicon here, but that would have been very silly. So what are we looking for? We're looking for more HP, we're looking for more damage. Flying would be great. He rolls rocks. Might as well. Why not? Alright, we got a whole 1 cent out of that. That's good. The champion belt's amazing. It's going to give us extra damage, which is exactly what we want. We got 2 of spades, which will double the amount of keys that we have. And yeah, I am being super duper frivolous with our money. But hey, we got the dollar, man. If you, like, you're not going to sit there and sit back and wait in the Bank of Isaac. You're going to spend, spend, spend. We've got an Eden streak here to win. Now, As far as how I'm going to do Gungeon and Isaac with the releases, I'm going to try to stagger the releases. You will probably not see Isaac and Gungeon come out on the same day. I'm not going to say never, but I'm going to try to keep it like alternating it back and forth. Because again, I know that it's a minority of my viewers that actually watch the Isaac stuff. Oh my God! Yeah, we had to do a double tap there. But yeah. I'm going to try to be somewhat reasonable. Even though I really want to get Gungeon content out right now, you may, like, in the first, like, week or so, we might have, like, a Gungeon video every single day or something like that. But for the most part, I don't want to go overboard with the content. But I do know that there's a healthy amount of people that do want to see Enter the Gungeon, and I definitely want to give those people the opportunity to know more about the new game. And put that, and on top of everything else, I just enjoy playing the game. Alright, yeah, so that right there is kind of what I was talking about. Yeah, we're just going to keep on skipping over. Hey, look, it's this room again. Oh, man, I sure hope that we get another Curse the Maze proc. It's my favorite thing in the world. Curse the Maze also, by the way, shuffles the room, so... And, again, we don't have any more bombs. I don't know how I keep finding myself in this situation. What exactly do we use our bombs on? I kind of swore that we had 3 at one point. Tapeworm. Tapeworm is going to give us a whole lot of range. In fact, unlimited range. And I'm kind of just over trying to get into the secret room at this point. An enterprising Isaac player would have tried to manipulate the mega troll bomb there to open up the curse room, but or the secret room. But instead, we're just going to keep on getting skipped around, and you know, curse the maze. Gotta love it. I have no idea how we didn't take a hit there. All right, let's just, you know what? Let's just get the heck off of this floor. I'm kind of over everything on this floor at this point. We didn't get a deal with the devil, which is surprising. We did get an HP upgrade and meat, which gives us damage as well. But mainly, I'm just trying to get rid of this and curse the maze, because as much as I love it, I'm moving on to bigger, better sort of thing, if you catch my drift. I'll go back and grab this full charge real quick, just in case. All right. So, yeah, I mean, meat's good. HP, damage, etc., etc. No curse the maze this time, which I know a lot of people are going to be disappointed with. There's a tinted rock. I'm going to use our only bond for that. We did get another soul heart, which is good. Call me lazy. Just don't call to come back. Got our bomb back, which is great. Good to know there's another arcade. I want to say the secret room's north of that room, but I'm not going to guarantee it. Not like on the other floor. Oh, that was close. Oh, apparently there was another hand. I was kind of wondering what was going on. That one, it seemed like that was like super duper delayed. There we go. Alright, we have the D4. No. It depends on, this floor will determine that. Let's put it that way. I don't mind going D4 all the time. It's just that on an Eden streak, it's kind of a different story. Depending on what we get for this floor will determine whether or not we D4. I know. You know, no balls, whatever. I know. I can already hear it. But hey, I am not as good as NL. Also, we turned into the keeper somehow. It's not the keeper. That's pay to play. It just makes us look like we have the keeper eyes. Yeah, I'm not as good at this game as Northern Lion is, which I know that everyone knows already. But unfortunately, that means that I'm also not good enough to facilitate taking a D100 D4. Like I've seen him re-roll some runs that I would never ever have dreamed of doing, and he still ends up winning them. You know, that's a testament to how good at the game he is. But for me, on the other hand, lowly old Sinvicta, I'm not gonna do that. If we just get like a god awful devil deal room item here or something, then maybe. Or never mind, I forgot that this is Depths 2. Well, I take that back. I feel like we missed a whole lot. Other than our opportunity to re-roll, but I, for some odd reason, thought we were still in Depths 1. I don't know why. Can you tell it's been a little while since I played Isaac? They get to deal with the devil, which is good. I'm a little bit sad that we didn't get to go play the blood bank. And we get the nail and Maw the Void, which is both really, really, really good. They're both super good, and we're going to super take them both. So the nail will give us soul hearts, the Whore of Babylon effect for one room, and allow us to break rocks, as you see here. And Maw the Void will allow us to create a black ring around it, around Isaac, whenever he charges up. You'll see a little inverted cross in a second. And then when he does this, that black ring gives us a chance to, if we kill anything with that black ring, it will deal a massive amount of damage to anything that touches it, and it also gives us a very high chance at getting a black soul heart. But taking damage against Fistula in this spot here is, there's no excuse for it. That was me trying to get a little bit cute with showing you all, you know, the possibility of us getting some much-needed soul hearts and failing at it. We are in not too good a shape right now, gotta be honest. And yeah, we didn't have to go that hard on the deal with the devil, but it could potentially work out for us. Potentially. It could also potentially kill us. I feel like we kind of just have to. Two of spades, okay. I was actually trying to fire off a little brimstone there. There we go. Again, I can't get too cute with Maw of the Void right now. We do not have enough defense to facilitate such a risky endeavor. You see how much damage it does, and the Maw of the Void damage, the Black Ring, does deal scaling damage based on your base damage. Oh man, just one soul heart. That's all we're asking for, or like a full charge or something. I'm very happy that I ended up buying the battery now. I don't know what it is about this room, but I absolutely hate it. Every time I see this room, I just get a really, like, just a huge sense of dread. Oh, wow, that was almost terrible. I thought that Diglett was dead, and we almost dodged right into him. Although, can you really call it a dodge if you run right into him? I don't think you can. Oh, if we have 41 keys, we might as well. Okay, this is the amount of red hearts that we're seeing here is comical at this point. Whoa! Two skeleton hands. Now that is very rare. Emperor card. Emperor card might be our ticket to freedom. In the chest anyway, but we've got a long way to go before we're there. Emperor card will automatically teleport us to the boss room. Which is very good for it's very, very good for getting around the aspect of, like, having to do a full clear on, like, say, the cathedral. But more commonly, it's used on the chest. So we're going to fight Skolex. I did use the nail here just to give us some extra damage. Not a particularly dangerous boss, but he can be annoying. And you also want to deal as much damage as possible when you are able to hit his tail like that. So, ideally now, what are we looking for a deal with the devil? Ideally, we want something like Juice's Shadow, 9 lives. Something that can give us the win. Anything that gives us extra insurance of, like, an extra life or something like that is ideal. I'm not going to take this HP. Do I take the HP? I actually am going to take the HP. And the reason being is because I'm hoping that we get a deal with the devil on Womb 2. And we get a chance to get a cheaper deal with the devil. So for those of you who don't know what that means, basically if you have nothing but soul hearts, the blue hearts that we have right now, and you take a deal with the devil, the base value of a soul heart deal with the devil is 3. You can never go above or below the cost of 3 soul hearts for a deal with the devil if you do not have any red hearts or any active red heart containers. You can have a red heart container but not have a red heart. And that doesn't count. You have to have at least half of a red heart. But with 1 HP, with 1 red heart container, we can actually take a 2 heart deal with the devil. Meaning that no matter how you look at it, we still end up ahead on the investment of getting an HP. The only downside is that we lose our polar invincibility, which, as you saw right there, would have saved us from possibly getting an extra hit or two. So, but the nail, given the fact that we are able to generate, albeit slowly, but we are still able to generate soul hearts, is big. On top of that, we get that nice damage boost as you saw right there on Wrath. And the ability to walk over rocks. Yeah, I don't think we need to do that. So it's going to come down to a nail carry here, along with a little brimstone and Daddy Longlegs. It's been a while since I actually got hit by one of the hosts. It's good. I mean, it keeps me in shape. Keeps me in Isaac shape, which I wish was a lot. I wish it was easy to stay in shape, in actual shape, as it was in Isaac shape. That's for sure. Got excited that maybe we saw Buttless Chub for a second. It's been a while since I've seen Buttless Chub too. So here's the hoping that we do get a deal with the devil. Maw the Void absolutely shreds Mom's heart. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs. If you can get close enough, that is, to actually do it. another deal with the devil. Deal with the devil is flying, so I will take Lord of the Pit. Obviously, we didn't make Hush, and this is not a Hush killing. This is not a Hush killing run anyway, so I have no qualms about losing out on Hush. Now, the only downside of Curse of Lost is that, of course, we are not going to know where we're going. Herp derp, Curse of Lost. But also, it presents us with an interesting predicament of, do we use the world, not the world card, but the emperor card now to make the cathedral easier, or do we tough it out and try to go for the emperor card in the chest? And I think we basically still save it for the chest, because if we get the blue baby with, like, say 2 or 3 HP, I think that we can burn him down with the amount of damage plus Maw of the Void and Daddy Longlegs. We can, I think, conceivably beat blue baby with 2 HP. Now, obviously, I don't want to find out if it's gonna take. I mean, I'm gonna do it, but I won't be happy about it. I don't relish in the fact, but I will revel in the fact. But I mean, if we have to, so I think we're gonna have to just bite the bullet here and hopefully we get lucky on the direction of Isaac. We're finally starting to get some payoffs there from Maw of the Void. And again, every full charge means that we get another soul heart, so we are looking very, very good. And of course, flying, the best defensive upgrade you can get. And our movement speed is excellent, our damage is fantastic. Nothing. Oh, and we got super duper lucky, and we found Isaac in our first try. And I am thankful for that. I don't know why I said that so weird. That didn't even sound like my regular voice. I am thankful for that. I don't know who I was trying to emulate there. Taking a little bit of bad damage here, which I'm not proud of. I have to fight the urge of trying to be cute with Maw of the Void. There we go. Almost got the kill. One more should do it. And this should be a one run. So we end up surviving yet another nightmare start. Nightmares in the sense that we really didn't know what we had when we began this run. But at the very end of the day, we were able to pull it out and grab a victory. Yeah, Tech Point 5 is great. Sure, we'll take Boom. We will take Lost Fly as well as our bum friend. We don't need the nail. Let's just go ahead and get it over with. So, happy to get win number 12 under our belt. Again, I will be staggering the releases of Isaac and Gungeon for a while. You're probably going to see a little bit more Gungeon than Isaac for the first couple of... first, like, week or two, I would say. And then things will start to kind of normalize a little bit. Hopefully you all understand my reasoning behind that. But if not, I do appreciate the support nonetheless on both series, because Gungeon's a great game. Of course, Isaac is a fantastic game as well. I wouldn't be doing a series if I didn't believe that. And I am happy to get win number 12. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a fantastic start to your weekends. And of course, until next time, so long, everybody!